mio l'orizzonte e mancan le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu.
Two, one, go. Hi. My name is, Roger Casey, and, it's my privilege to serve as the ninth president of McDaniel College. Let's see. You wanted to talk about why I want to cut down all the trees on campus. No, that's not it. That's a different interview. I remember now. The AAUP faculty salary study is. That's not it either. I'm talking about whom? That name doesn't ring a bell. What? Muller. Oh! Joyce. That's the woman who's going to Cuba or something. Frankly, I don't know what to say. Usually there's this phenomenal person who comes over here, talks to me about these interviews like this, sits down with me, gives me notes, gives me ideas about what to say, and she's leaving, and I just don't know what to say. Joyce Muller, I truly just don't know what to say.
When I first heard that Joyce Muller was retiring from the college, I immediately entered the five stages of grief. Stage two, anger. This can't be true. I can't believe she's doing this to me. Why is this happening to me? Stage three, bargaining. Joyce, if I never ever ask you to make another poster for the English department or to write another bio for a visiting lecturer or a poet, would you please, please stay, huh? Stage four, depression. What's it all mean, anyway? Why is it worth coming to work if Joyce Muller won't be here on the Hill? We'll all just be blown up into cinders someday anyway. The final stage, stage five, acceptance. Joyce, I've come to understand how important this next step in your life is for you, and I wish you nothing but the best during your post-McDaniel times.
Joyce has been here such a long time that when Roger announced her retirement, everyone gasped. They couldn't believe that she would no longer be here. Joyce has been such an important part of our community, and especially with the Hill magazine, for example, and I have to thank her for some very nice articles in the Hill about me.
When I think of our friend Joyce, the word that comes to my mind most often is she is such a navigator. She navigated the campus through the name change with beauty, with skill, with insight.
When I think about the time of the name change, and I try not to think about it much, we couldn't have done it without Joyce. Absolutely couldn't. She was the head of the committee, one of the co-chairs of the committee that selected the name. But more importantly, she worked with the branding, and we did a wonderful job of branding McDaniel. And the name change made a difference the very next year. A lot of the credit for that goes to Joyce.
Well, Joyce, retirement is upon you. But I can remember lots of things that we'd worked together on. Three inaugurations. I think you're retiring before you ever deal with another one. Umpteen commencements that we've had interchanges with. Can you possibly forget the name change? 3 weeks to get this little brochure out and write the program and make the announcement, and you were the driving force behind all that.
The other thing that really has impacted my friendship with Joyce is the fact that she's one of the brightest people I know. She is so well-read.
If you've ever had the opportunity to visit Joyce in her office, one of the things you might marvel at is all of the stuff that is laying around in her office. And as you look around, it becomes evident to you that what she has is essentially an archive of over 25 years of college history. And I think that that is a great measure of Joyce's contribution to the institution, and a contribution that I think will be missed starting in the fall of 2014.
One thing that people might not know is that Joyce has supported the Carroll County Human Relations Commission, which I'm a member of. Each year she has helped us by publishing the brochure for our annual dinner. And this past year she was actually the highlighted speaker for our dinner. So Joyce, you've done a wonderful job, both not at the college, but also here in the community.
Joyce, you were here and a mentor of mine when I was a student from 1984 to 1988. And then I came back in 2003, and you've been a mentor of mine since I was here as a teacher. And I always expected you to still be here and a mentor of mine when I retire in 20 years. So I don't know what you're doing, but I hope you're just resting up for a couple of years, and you'll be back to join me at my retirement party in 20 years, if I even make it that far. Thanks, Joyce, for everything you've done.
Joyce Muller. I can't believe we're not going to have Joyce Muller. Every time we sat down for lunch and discussed the Great Decision series, there would be these topics that, interestingly enough, I happen to be working on. So we discussed everything from international humanitarian law, responsibility to protect, Germany as the behemoth within the European Union, you name it. It pretty much ran the gamut. And it was always a pleasure and always just a wonderful, wonderful group of people that I'm really happy that I was able to get to know.
When I think about the relationship that Joyce has been able to obtain with Town Gown Relations, I'm reminded of what she has done in such a worthwhile way with the Great Decisions Foreign Policy Association. Think how many people have come on campus for the first time and have really become friends of the college because of the intense work she did to bring speakers and all kinds of scholars to help us understand in a better way during January, February, and March the whole concept of foreign policy.
Joyce brought ambassadors, heads of state, you name it, all to McDaniel College for what she single-handedly put together as a Great Decisions Forum to discuss foreign policy.
So Joyce has been such an incredible supporter of libraries. When I first arrived here, she let me know all the incredibly wonderful people that I'd be working with in Carroll County and all the libraries, and also all of the great donors that she knows personally that have given to the Hoover Library. Over the years, Joyce has done amazing things to help us get the word out about the Hoover Library and all of the great publications, and especially Hill Magazine articles.
Hi, Joyce. It's been a pleasure working with you through all these years. One day, if I'm ever invited back for a smart talk, I hope somebody remembers to borrow these chairs. Thank you so much, and I wish you the best of luck.
I've been fortunate to work with Joyce on a variety of projects. The one that probably comes to my mind most is when she decided to have my first year seminar course come over to my house and have me toss pizzas around my kitchen. And I think I'm still finding green pepper and pepperoni behind the radiator in the kitchen to this day. Other projects I've had the opportunity to work with Joyce would be one that really I'm very thankful for is the comic strip exhibit that we had in 2011, where she put together a public relations promotional campaign that I thought was really outstanding in terms of generating interest, sending out flyers, regarding the guest speakers, the exhibit itself. Forever grateful for that support and interest in that project.
And of course, will you ever forget Fearless and Bold? Took me 7 years to write it, and it took you a year to produce it, work with the director and the editor, and we 200 pictures, and we got it out. And I can't thank you enough for all of our professional dealings, but also you are just a personal friend, and I look forward to many more opportunities to visit with you.
Thank you, Joyce, for all you've done for the faculty, especially all of our last minute. We're having this event. Please publicize it as fast as you can. We appreciate it, and you'll never be replaced.
Thank you, Joyce, very much for all you have done the last few years to for our students and our Arabic and Middle Eastern Studies program, putting it on the map and making a difference. Thank you so much, and we wish you all the best.
Hi, Joyce. This actually came from your office, and it went to London, England with Ira Domser, and it went to Westchester University with me when over Jan term. And so I wanted to thank you for that. And I also wanted to thank you for this. Da 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 da. Every year we go through this, Marshall's and the communications office printing the program for graduation. And it's been fabulous working with you, and I hope to see you around campus sometime. Ciao.
Joyce, best of luck in your future. And thank you so much for your advice across the years, especially this, which you gave me, to preserve my smiling, to preserve my smiling muscles once when I had to be smiling constantly. Have a great retirement.
Good luck, Joyce, from Corey and Smolder the Dragon.
All the best to you in your retirement.
Cheers.
First, I want to wish you a great, 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 great retirement, but I want to thank you for all the work you did for the French Film Festival and to advertise so many other things, such as French Day, and to make it known. Without you, nobody would really know about it other than my colleagues in the department. So thank you so much. Merci, merci mille fois, Joyce.
And I can only say, buen viaje a Cuba.
شكرا يا جويس على كل أتعابك ونتمنى لك كل السعادة والنجاح.
Joyce, I admire you and I am grateful to call you friend.
Well, I'm not going to say goodbye to Joyce because I am so excited that she's going to retire so that we can play, read books, go places, see movies. She and I have been friends for decades and decades. There's nobody who has worked harder for McDaniel than Joyce. So I'm sorry to have her go for McDaniel, but I am excited to have her come back into my life as a friend, retiree. I plan to retire again this year too.
Joyce is retired, I need to be. Nice.
We'll miss you, Joyce!
No, let's do no more deadlines.
No more deadlines!
What else?
No more jaywalking!
See you at tailgating!
Alright, so we got the deadlines, we got the party, we got the tailgating.
And why didn't Joyce write the script for this?
I know!
We wrote the script without you!
Isn't it great?
Okay, we ready? Joyce, this is Robert Kotcher, Captain Robert, as I am known in the department. And I just want to tell you that there's no hard feelings. I don't really understand why you never publicized me more in the college's materials. What's that? Later. But, you know, I'm sure you did what you thought was best for the college, and I respect you for that. So I hope that you have a great retirement, and I really hope your successor wants to get my face a lot more often in promotional materials. But tell that, Joyce, that's not your concern. Have a great retirement.
Joyce, thank you so much for 20 years of cooperation. You and your staff have done a tremendous job in advertising many, many of our events, like German-American Day, now for 20 years, a Taste of Islam Ramadan dinner, and recently Taste of Arabia. Personally, I would like to thank you and Kim Ash for running a story about me in The Hill magazine. And Robert Katcher, I'm sorry, man, you know, I really feel bad for you. But you still have time. You have another 25 years, so who knows? Maybe they will run a story about you. So I wish you all the best in your retirement. Alles Gute. Danke. Und auf Wiedersehen.
You have been a remarkable friend, a remarkable colleague for the 4 years that I've been here. I wish we could have had 30 years together, because it's easy for me to understand all that you have done for this remarkable institution in the time that you've been here. You do more things past your job description than any person that I've ever met before. It truly will take half a dozen people to replace you when you're gone, and I just want to say what an incredible, incredible pleasure that it's been to work with you. And I want to thank whoever it is that wrote that script so that I could say those things. But I wish you the absolute best, and I will miss you dearly.